Omo lati de. But don't say it was right. You say I'm always late. But you never give me time. You say I'm paranoid. You're the one who's hiding from me. I've been thinking about it lately. And you don't love you only feel like. What you bad be telling? What you till out? Just like water, we no get telling me. I just wanna be free.
To get breakfast downstairs. This is my last day in Serez Resort. I'm so sad. I went down for breakfast yesterday, but I feel like the breakfast options aren't as much as I'd like. But they do have a lot of like Indonesian cuisine, which is nice if you want that in the morning instead of like your average kind of continental breakfast. But I just wish they had more. But their pancakes are amazing, like really, really fluffy. And you can eat outdoors, although I don't think I'll be eating outdoors today. Because it's raining. So I'm all packed and I'm ready to go to Manduk. So I'm going to Manduk Moding Plantation Hotel Resort type place. It's amazing. I'm so nervous about going because it's just so big and so vast, and it's got an incredible pool, and I'm just thinking how I'm going to shoot it, but God is going to help me. And yeah, I'm really excited. So I'm just going to head down to breakfast, jump in a cab, get into my shuttle, and we are off to North Bali today. And ignore my wig lifting. Ain't nobody gluing wigs today, honey. Mm-mm. It's 8 o'clock in the morning. Ain't nobody seeing nobody. This is a transportation look situation. I'm also waiting for my clothes to dry because I want to wear something a bit warmer, but doesn't look like it's drying anytime soon, but fingers crossed. But yeah, I'm going to be sad to leave this room, but it's another adventure we're going on. We can do this.
Wow, okay. Okay.
We have a common book.
Okay.
We have menu in the restaurant and okay. We have information book to activity in the hotel.
Okay.
We have water free.
Thank you.
We have a tea, coffee free.
Okay. A mini bar. Fridge.
This okay. Is the price per mini bar.
Thank you. Hi guys, so look at me. What is this? Okay, so I arrived at Mondok. Mondok, yeah, was difficult to get to. Also, a lot of these tour guide people are bloody crooks, yeah? And okay, I can't really go outside, but basically I bought a shuttle bus ticket to Mondok for 130 rupiah. I thought that's what it was going to be. I asked him specifically, is the driver going to take me to my hotel? He was like, yeah, just tell your driver where your hotel is. We got to Mondok, he just dropped us in the middle of bloody nowhere and was just like, oh, this is the shuttle stop. If you want me to take you to your hotel, it's going to be more expensive. I was like, okay, first of all, that's a lie. So that's annoying. I was like, okay, how much is it? And then he was asking for 150. We're already in Mondok. Think about it. We drove from Ubud to Mondok, which takes about 2 hours or an hour and 30 minutes. But to take me to my hotel in Mondok from a place in Mondok is more than driving from... Really? At this point, I just got so angry because I'm just so tired of the extortion. I'm tired of it. Like, I understand that our currency is more, but sometimes enough is enough. Like, if a price is a price, just keep it at that price instead of now asking for more. Like, if I bought the ticket for a certain amount and I asked him if it's going to take me to my hotel, it should just take me to my hotel. This is one of the things about Southeast Asian. This is also something that irritates me about Oyinbo people, how they see some destinations as less problematic than others. This constant extortioning, trying to extort tourists, happens all over, not just in Africa, and I don't appreciate the fact that Bali's made out to be paradise. It is, yeah, but there's a system of extortion, and I understand why, but I feel like it should just have the rep that it has instead of making it out to be, don't get me wrong, it is gorgeous, but there's also some problems, and I just feel like that's how a lot of places in Africa are. In fact, Africa in general is gorgeous, but there's problematic stuff, but that no one mentions that about Bali. It's just Bali's great, Bali's this, Bali's that, unless you read like in-depth like blog posts that will tell you about stuff like this. But it's just really irritating. You think something's going to be one thing and then it turns out to be something else. But all of this was starting to grate on my nerves. Like, people in the van were starting to have arguments with the driver. Started swearing at people, like people who decided that they weren't going to pay. Me too. I was thinking, oh, I don't want to pay either, but I thought, oh, am I going to be made out to be like an angry black woman because everyone else there was white? And they were like, no, we're not paying either. And I thought, yeah, go on. And then he started swearing at them, and I thought, you know what, listen, I'm a woman. And the guy that he was swearing at and was arguing with him was a guy, and I'm a woman. I don't know whether one minute he's just going to chuck me, hit me round my face when I'm least, you know what I mean? Like, I have to be careful. So I just said, like, just drop me. And he literally dropped my bags in the middle of the road, and I was in the middle of nowhere. I was praying. I was like, God, like, please provide a way for me just to get to this hotel. And thank God, God came through. And at this point, I was just like, I'm so done with this trip. Like, not the trip, but you know when I'm also on my period, so, and I'm in heat, and it's raining, and it's humid, and you're bleeding, and it's just like, I don't need to be going through this, do you know what I mean? And the driver wouldn't let me use the toilet. So it was just really, just trash, really, just really, really awful. And I just thought, oh, when I get here, I don't know if it's going to be worth all this hassle. Like, is it really gonna, like, you know when you go through stuff and it just takes the pain away? But you know what, I was wrong. I got here, I thought I was only getting a room, but it turns out I'm in a villa. See how God works. Listen, double for your trouble, man, double for your trouble. So we basically, you have to get a cart from the beginning of the hotel. It's quite a large estate, and then you have to drive down, and that's kind of like the pathway down. Then you've got these lounges here. It's been raining, so it is a little bit like wet. And then you've got a table outside, which is really nice, and the door's open, so I'm definitely letting in a bunch of mosquitoes that are gonna want to eat me. But it's cool because I have mosquito repellent. Anyway, so I'm in the living room. It is a little bit dark, living it, and I've also got the thingy on. Okay, this is better. Oh, see what the difference lighting makes. Okay, so this is the lounge area, so this is like, you know, settee type thing. And then this is a little table with a little nice like fruit basket. Don't know why I'm holding the camera like that. And then I've got a little chair here. And then the piece de resistance. Look, like what? I've always wanted to stay in a four-poster bed. Always. Don't know about those white sheets though. Don't know about those white sheets, especially when I'm on this time of the month thing. But anyway, so this is the view from outside. In fact, actually, no. Look at this. What? Like, we're in the hills, basically. I just, honestly, I'm just so thankful. Like, without God, honestly, none of this would even be possible. I'm telling you right now. Like, this is far above anything I could have hoped for or imagined. This bed is absolutely stunning. Like, the detail, honestly, is just amazing. So if you go around, you go kind of like to the bathroom area. There's a sink here. Oh, look, they've got water. I like that. Cupboard and then the toilet. And then they've got a really nice bath here, which is, I love these little baths that you can really take soaks in and stuff. So this is like a vanity area where you've got your mirror and your table and then some candles and stuff. You've got another sink. I'm not sure why there's two sinks, but hey. Then there's an indoor shower and then... Oh, this happened last time. This is so embarrassing. Okay, and then outdoor shower, baby. I'm so excited. Look how dope that looks. Oh my gosh. So there's that. And then you just come round again. And then there's the bedroom. I just can't believe I have this all to myself. Like, this is amazing. I mean, I don't think I could stay here for more than a couple of days. Like, I'm glad it's only 2 days because even though I do like my own company, it is very secluded. Like, it's so secluded that they gave me a mobile phone to contact the reception desk so that they can like drive down in their little like golf cart thing and pick me up if I need to go up there. And there's also nowhere really to get food apart from the restaurant, which is kind of annoying. So that's that. But their customer service is absolutely A1. I do feel a little bit embarrassed because like I'm on my period and I just hope I haven't sat on something. Either way, the content I'm going to give for them is going to be the best I can do, so I can make up for it. But yeah, so the place is amazing.
Oh, my lady, you tell me I'm wrong, but don't say what's right. You say I'm always late, but you never give me time. You say I'm paranoid. You're the one who's hiding from me. Oh, I've been thinking about it lately. And you don't love the only feel like. What you bad be telling? What you tell out? Just like water, we don't get telling me. I just wanna be free. Just want to be me. Sometimes love might drown you. Without nowhere to run to, hearts may be wrong, wow. But you need you to pull through. So I choose to be happy.
I've come back from dinner and look at what they've done. How gorgeous. I mean, wow. Let me go from the side. It looks so romantic. Just so pretty. Can't wait to go to sleep tonight. I'm gonna watch a couple of DVDs. Let me just flip this. whoa. Sorry, it's a bit dark in here. This place in general is quite dark. They don't have a lot of lights, hence there's a lot of candles, but it's super romantic and I don't even mind being here by myself. It's amazing. It's like everything I've ever wanted in a room, especially like in a romantic getaway type place. It's just so lush. And it's like something you really want to do if you treat yourself. I mean, just, ugh, like, what? Incredible. Thank God for the blessings. It's amazing. So yeah, I'm going to watch some DVDs. Well, not some, just one. Because I actually need to go to sleep soon. Probably at 11. I'm going to wake up at about 6. Get out of here by 7. Shoot until 9:30. Then 9:30, I'm going to Munduk Waterfall. Just going to see the waterfall, sightsee, shoot a little bit there, and have lunch and come back to the hotel at about 3. Then I'm gonna have a massage in the spa because it's a resort and a spa. This place is like top luxury. I mean, the customer service is, I've never seen anything like this in my life. Like, they bring things to your room, they give you a little mobile phone so you can call them if you need anything. And I needed an electric heater because it's a little bit cold here, and they're just gonna bring it to my villa. Just like that. So if you're looking for a romantic getaway or just for something really luxurious, like you want to be secluded, you want some privacy, you want some alone time, but you also want like luxury, this place, like, it's amazing, amazing. So yeah, they're going to bring an electric heater. Tomorrow I'm getting a massage. I actually haven't had a massage since I've been here. I've just been so busy like the whole time. And then tomorrow's my last night here, and then I'm off. To be honest, I can't spend too long in a quiet place like this. It's just a bit, 2 days is a perfect amount of time just to be, just to have like proper tranquility. Like, oh, I'm gonna try and make the most of it. I'm not gonna lie, I wish I could have a third night because then I could really make the most of the peace and the quiet, but it's cool. Next stop after that is Seminyak. I feel like I'm a 80s rock band going on a tour around Bali. But yeah, after that is Seminyak, and that's going to be fun. I'm going to be there for quite a while. I'm going to be there for about 5 days, so 5 or 6 days. So that's going to be dope.